Welcome back to Views with Here's Your JF News. This is Jerome Houston. Today's story, there seems to be a sort of accomplishment with Disney with their purchase of 20th Century Fox, as well as the IPs that's under it, including Avatar, Lucasfilm, and even Marvel. I got a feeling that this is, as the kids today call it, Cap. So let's go ahead and get right into it. All right. So we see that Bob Iger, CEO of Disney and everything, he is currently in a proxy war against Nelson Peltz. Okay. And he's trying his darndest to go ahead and keep the board seats alive as it is. All right. And the fact of the matter is that, well, he has a pretty uphill, basically an uphill battle going. And just like this past weekend, a week and all that, it was stated that, you know, somebody said that Disney's made over $12 billion and stuff thanks to the decisions of Bob Iger. Well, I'm having a hard time believing that. So Bob Iger and his crew at Disney are duking it out on what looks to be like a big showdown with some heavy hitters like Nelson Peltz, Jay Rizzullo, Ike Perlmutter, and even the Blackwells gang. Okay, so they're throwing out these different super detailed reports to their shareholders, and it's got me wondering, can we take this in for a face value, or is Disney just playing with these numbers just to make themselves look good? It's also pretty clear that Disney's loving the buzz for some iffy report claiming that they've raked in $1 billion from Star Wars, tripling what they paid for it. But you know what? It's always giving the Hollywood glitz the real world check, okay? So basically, something's fishy about these details that's not highlighted. Maybe it's time for Disney to stop playing games with their investors and fess up to what they've dropped, that the fact that they've dropped the ball. All right, they've got a big mess to fix and stuff, and they got to fix the mess they've made, because Disney had its say on Marvel, Pixar, and Star Wars. Okay, so here's a lowdown. Just a few days back, Disney and Bob Iger were all hands on deck trying to block a takeover attempt from big names like Nelson Peltz, okay? Jay Rizzullo, as well as Ike Perlmutter. Now, they're guarding the treasure trove of Disney shares worth somewhere between $2.5 to $3 billion. And it got me thinking, if Peltz and his crew from Triant aren't shaking things up big time, then why would Disney even try to sweat it? You know, it seems like they're laser focused on trying, and it's pretty much ignoring Blackwells. I mean, that's got to mean something. So I'm pretty sure that y'all have seen on channels like Valiant Renegade, where they put out like a bunch of fancy slides on social media trying to show off stuff like enduring franchises taking up their big hits like Frozen, Toy Story, Avengers, and Star Wars. They even throw around a number saying Star Wars has given them a return of almost three times what they paid, which sounds impressive until you actually take a look at the fine print that's at the bottom of the slide, okay? Even Valiant Renegade put in on this that, you know, it says that they're basically saving the money that they've made versus what they've spent on these movies since buying their rights. But here's the crazy part about it. It's a bit of guessing game, because there's like their kind of money and they expect to make in the future too. Like, for example, The Rise of Skywalker, as people on YouTube, myself included, call it The Rise of Palpatine, because Rey is not Rey Skywalker. She's not Skywalker. She's Palpatine. But anyway, that movie's been out for less than 5 years now. It released before the start of the pandemic and stuff in the U.S., and it's already on Disney Plus. And they're banking on making more money off of it in the next 5 years in some sort of imaginary, magical way. And get this, the cash they're talking about doesn't even include from the theme park rides or new shows from Disney Plus that are tied to these big movie names. Okay, they're just talking about the cost to make and the market of movies. All right, anything else that's extra and stuff, well, that's not really part of the main plan, like what it costs to show these movies around the world or to keep lights on in the studios. That's not their math. Okay, it's not in their math. All right, and stuff feels a little suspicious or suspect to me. And Disney's playing a game, counting chickens before they hatch and leaving out a bunch of costs to make their numbers look even better. Makes you wonder what they're trying to hide. You know, this is nothing surprising to me, because this has always been a part of the Disney playbook. Okay, you even see this from Bob Iger during the investor calls and stuff, the shareholder, not shareholders calls, the quarterly meetings and stuff. And he tried to list the difference, the different accomplishments and everything. But in reality, he's been glossing over a few details and also counting in the money that's going to be, that's expected to be made in the future, when, rather than telling the truth itself. Okay, so let me lay it out straight to you. We're talking big Disney names like Star Wars, Marvel, Pixar's Toy Story, and Frozen. And guess what? None of the massive cash that they've dropped on park attractions gets counted for. Like, for example, Star Wars alone, they've poured in around, like, what, about $2.5 billion into those Galaxy's Edge theme parks. But not to mention a hotel that didn't quite hit the mark, okay? And I'm talking about, you know, Galaxy Star Cruiser. On top of that, throw in another cool $2 billion for a bunch of Disney Plus series. We're taking three rounds of The Mandalorian, Bad Batch, Clone Wars, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Book of Boba Fett. And don't forget about the big Andor series with that they've paid $250 million to shell out. And why are these numbers showing up in the defense reports itself? You know, seems to me like they can't quite tie enough bucks back into the investments to make the math look good on paper. All right. And here's a bigger kicker out of it with the whole Star Wars deal. Y'all remember that, right? Well, if you look at the report itself, you'll see Mandalorian and Grogu. You don't see Daisy Ridley as Rey Palpatine. You don't even see Kylo Ren. So that right there in a nutshell shows that he's basically admitted that the Disney sequels are not successful without admitting it. Okay, so yeah, that's true. The very parts of Disney Star Wars universe that they've decided to say, oh, these, well, not part of the profit we're talking about, at least according to the fine print, but they're kind of playing both sides because they're also hinting that the cash from all the Mandalorian and Grogu toys and stuff counts. But it's not the Disney sequels, though. It's just not the big bucks they took to make and promote the series that got everyone buying that merch in the first place. And also, here's another piece of that crazy Disney puzzle. They dropped this billion dollar figure about Star Wars. And then they make this claim that floating around that Disney's made $12 billion off Star Wars. Doing some quick math that sounds like it adds up, because Disney spent about $4.05 billion to get it and then supposedly made back nearly three times that. But this is the crazy part right here. This is where it really gets funny. The $4 billion price tag for Star Wars wasn't just for the movies. It's just like saying you bought the house for a price of the mansion. I mean, this sounds impressive, but the real cost is and what you're actually talking about might not match up. All right. And I'm going to set some things straight. I'm not in Disney's shoes, not the CEO, and I'm not working for Disney in part, not getting any benefits from Disney. Nor am I trying to draft up some sort of report and stuff for the SEC. But here's the big deal. Disney shelled out over $4 billion to get their hands on Lucasfilm, which, yes, also brought Star Wars to the fold. But let's also remember this. That bundle also included other big names like Indiana Jones. And we saw that the Dial of Destiny was the flop in the movie theaters. That one had to hurt Disney's pocketbook. And we all remember the panic over that. And let's not forget, see, the only season of Willow was only available on Disney Plus, and it was taken off. Okay, but another thing that you want with that $4 billion Lucasfilm deal, there were some real gems like the industrial light and magic and Skywalker sound. And it also makes you wonder how much of that purchase price was actually going to for those behind the scenes powerhouses. Could it be that a cool $1 billion or even more was for those parts of the company that aren't as front and center as Star Wars? You know, that's also something interesting to think about, and we can all ponder that together. And it's also something to think about, especially when considering the overall value Disney got for their money. So if you think that if you think that's crazy, there's more to the story on the same page. Take a look at also Toy Story and the Avengers. All right. What do you think about when you see those names and pictures? It gives you off the vibe that we're talking about a whole Pixar and Marvel universe, right? But that's not even the reality itself. And we're also talking about a few movies here, just the main Avengers films, like the original Age of Ultron, Infinity War, and Endgame. Now, why do you think Disney would just spotlight those four? They're just sticking to the Avengers label by dodging mentioning the entire Marvel lineup. They don't want to admit, they don't want to admit to the flops of Marvel Phase 4 and stuff. That's pretty simple right there. Of course, they're not going to admit to that because those movies lost the company money. Because if they did, they'd have to count to all the other movies, including the ones from, like I said, Phases 4 and 5. And let's be honest, they haven't been exactly hitting home runs either. This has been playing it smart, you know, basically cherry picking what looks to make a big picture seem shinier than it might actually be. All right. Now, if Disney was still selling their Star Wars Marvel stuff like big plays like Netflix or even Amazon Prime, like back in the day, we'd be having a whole different ballgame right now. But that ship sailed, basically. Now everything's parked on Disney Plus for a long haul, which basically means Disney's making money off its own back. And they're counting on making big bucks, just not now, but also betting on what they'll rake in over the next decade from their own pocket. And if Disney's up for it, they better answer all the questions about their findings with some real hard numbers on how much they've really spent on these Lucasfilm, Marvel, and Pixar projects, especially with the ones that didn't exactly hit the mark over the last couple of years. Because where I'm standing, as the other analysts and other YouTubers are saying, the numbers they're throwing around just don't add up at all. Okay, so let me know your thoughts about this in the comments below. Also, be sure to include any additional thoughts or details you have on this particular topic. If you enjoy what I share in this video, go ahead, smash the like button, share far wide across social media. And if you have done so already, you enjoyed all the content I put out there, go ahead, subscribe to the channel, click the bell notification, so that way you'll be notified of future uploads and updates. Until then, peace.